Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. Today we're going to talk about conversions from polar coordinates to rectangular coordinates. Polar coordinates are found with the ordered pair r theta, where r is the radius and theta is the angle created by that radius. And then we're going to also talk about rectangular coordinates, and that's found with the ordered pair xy. Now let's take a quick look at a drawing here of a unit circle on the Cartesian coordinate plane so that we can describe how polar coordinates and rectangular coordinates are related. This here is called a unit circle because the radius of this circle is just one unit. So that means at this point on the circle, the rectangular coordinates are 1, 0. Up here, the coordinates are 0, negative 1. Back here, the coordinates are negative 1, 0. And down here, the coordinate is 0, negative 1. As we move around the circle, we start here at 0 degrees. This would be 90 degrees, 180 degrees, 270 degrees, and back to 360. So, like we know, the distance around the circle is 360 degrees. Now, let's say we have a radius r that extends from the center of the circle to an endpoint, to an edge of the circle, to the edge of the circle. And that radius we're going to call r. Where the radius touches the circle, we're going to draw a vertical line straight down, which creating a right angle. All right, and the angle created by radius r is theta. Now we say that the base of this right triangle is x units, and the height is y units. And putting that in place, we can say that the rectangular coordinates for this point are just x, y. So that there is pretty straightforward when dealing with rectangular coordinates. Now let's see how this right triangle helps us to express a rectangular coordinate as a polar coordinate. So let's start off with cosine. So if we were to take the cosine of angle theta there, we know that the relationship of cosine, the relationship of the sides when dealing with cosine, is the adjacent side over the hypotenuse, which would just be x over r. And if we were to cross multiply to express this in terms of x, we see that x is equal to r cosine theta. If we were to try to evaluate that right triangle using the sine trig function, sine has a relationship of opposite over hypotenuse, so that would be y over r. And to express that in terms of y, we cross multiply and we come up with y is equal to r sine theta. And last but not least, let's look at tangent theta. Tangent relationship is opposite over adjacent, so that would just be y over x. All right, now using this information, we see that the x coordinate can also be expressed as r cosine theta. And we see that the y coordinate can be expressed as r sine theta. R sine theta. So we see that this point, x, y, in rectangular form, can also be expressed as r cosine theta, r sine theta. So we're going to use these equations here to help us look at a real live example and figure out how to convert from polar to rectangular. All right, let's say we started off with a polar coordinate of 3, 270 degrees, and we want to convert that into something that's rectangular. All right, let's go ahead and draw another unit circle. We're not going to fill in everything, but just enough here just to get us started for this for tutorial purposes. And we're going to label all the points here. So this here is 1, 0. At the top here, 0, 1. Back here, negative 1, 0. And then down here at 0, negative 1. And we're going to put our angles back on here as well, 180. 270 and 360. All right, for this particular problem, we know that the angle theta is 270 degrees, so that puts us at this point here on the y-axis. So now let's just rewrite x is equal to r cosine theta. We know from the problem that r is 3, and we're taking the cosine of 270 degrees. All right, as I stated earlier, when we're looking at the cosine corresponds to the x coordinate, and we see at 270 degrees, the x coordinate is 0. So we're going to say the cosine of 270 degrees is 0. And then we're going to evaluate. 3 times 0 gives us 0. So that's our x-coordinate. Now let's find our y-coordinate. Y is equal to r sine theta. And again, we're saying r is 3 because that's given. And we're looking for the sine at 270 degrees. When we look at 270 degrees, we find the point, and we see that the corresponding y value is negative 1, so it's going to be 3 times negative 1, and that corresponds to a negative 3. So we found that our rectangular coordinate is 0, negative 3, when our polar coordinate is 3, 270 degrees. All right, that sums it up for this video from Spell Tutorial Services. Please friend us on our Facebook page and subscribe to our YouTube page. Actually, do both if you can. Thank you for watching and have a great evening.